Hey, I'm Kylie of Kylie M Interiors, blogger, online paint color expert, and e-design specialist. Today we're taking a look at a color that a lot of you have asked for in my YouTube comments and Instagram comments, and that is Sherwin-Williams Modern Gray. And thank you for those comments. They really help me know what's on your guys' radar, and then I can talk about it. And I like to talk. This is a good thing. So there's no wonder you guys are wondering about Modern Gray. It is a tricky one. They say it's Modern Gray, but it's actually further away from gray than you think. But before we get into that, I want to talk about its LRV. LRV is light reflectance value. It tells you how light or dark a paint color is on a scale of 0, which is black, to 100, which is white. Modern Gray sits at 62, which is my magical number, because when you don't know where to start with a room, you can't figure out what color, you don't know what depth, light, dark, medium. If you find colors that have an LRV around 62 to 65, it's a great place to start. Some of today's most popular colors are in this range because they seem to work in the average room with the average amount of light. Now, every paint color brand shows the LRV in different spots, but if you go to my blog, I have two articles written. You'll learn everything you need to know, and it's actually very, very simple. Now, so that's the LRV 62, puts it in the light range. It's right smack dab in the middle of the light range, not close to being an off-white, definitely not a heavy color. If you have a super bright room, it will wash out quite a bit. For colors not to wash out, you need a really reasonable degree of depth, so this will happen with any color. If you have a dark room, it's gonna look a little bit drab, chalky, dirty kind of. That's gonna happen with neutrals. The only way to counteract that is to add more light to your room or to pick colors that have more color in them to try and counteract those shadows a little bit. Now, let's do some comparison. So, undertones can be tricky, right? And every neutral has undertones. Modern Gray is actually more, could be Modern Taupe. Taupe has purple-pink undertones, and this guy does favor that bit of pink. And it's very subtle. You wouldn't notice it much. If you put it with products that had a lot of green in them, you might see it a bit more, but it's a really very passive, soft, gentle color. One that, like, I'm not a big pink undertone fan. Like, I have Benjamin Moore Balboa Mist on my walls here, and that's about as pink as I like to go. This doesn't scare me at all. It's just a bit warmer than what's on my walls for frame of reference. Now, let's do some comparisons. Agreeable Gray. So, Agreeable Gray is actually a grayish, and it leans closer to gray than beige. But you can see Modern Gray is warmer than Agreeable Grayish. Agreeable Gray. You can see that warmth there, and Agreeable Gray can also pick up a tiny wink of green, and we can see that because that wink of green helps us see that soft pink in there. Once in a blue moon, I've seen this flash a bit of green, but I find that it's more of a situational thing. It could be picking up from the outside, light bulbs, that kind of thing, because generally speaking, it's going to favor that little bit of a taupe undertone. Let's look at it with Alpaca. So Alpaca is a taupe paint color, and look at how much warmer that is. Again, so we're in a considerably warm paint color. Surprisingly warm, actually. Popular Gray, this is another taupe-ish color. Again, you see all that beige in there? It's still a taupe paint color. It just sure as heck isn't a gray. Worldly Gray, this is another grayish. Now it favors a reasonable green undertone. Again, it helps us see that really soft color in there. I don't want the word pink to scare you, because it actually suits an awful lot of tiles and carpets. It's actually quite appropriate for many homes. Now, I want to show you a few colors that it likes to be partnered with, in case you're doing a palette or you're curious. Tinsmith is interesting. It might be a flash cool for it. Maybe Silver Plate could be better, but I don't mind that combo on a room-to-room basis. A New Gray. I can pick up a flash of green, but I don't mind it there. Ooh, so there we go. So look at that, right? That's all good. But then we take that little flash of green in there out. So versatile gray. So we just shifted a little bit there. A little bit more green, a little bit more taupe. And that's why Modern Gray likes versatile gray, because it has that taupe in there. So of the two, yes, I would go to versatile gray. Super pretty combo, right? Moderate white. It's a soft, warm white. Again, it actually does a better job of showing the pink in there. This will be pretty. Silver Strand, so pretty, love it. Now, if you have a north-facing room, you will see Modern Gray leaning back and looking that little bit grayer for sure. It'll never look cold, but it will not look as warm as it maybe does now and compared to those. That can happen with east-facing afternoon light, western morning light. Now, if you have south-facing room, you've got a lot of sunshine coming in. It can happen a bit with eastern morning light, but a lot with western afternoon light. As those warm sun rays are gonna lean this color into its warmth, you might notice the pink a bit more. You might notice a little bit more beige coming up. I don't expect it to ever look beige. I suppose if you partnered it with gray products, like if you had gray tile and you throw that in a south-facing room, it might look beige in comparison. But generally speaking, it's gonna hold itself as a really soft, pretty taupe color. I bet you this goes with a lot of the tiles and countertops from the 2000s because a lot of them had pink undertones. Now, one more thing, don't go. White paint colors. You're probably gonna wanna paint your trim. So let's look at a few. High reflective white, that's a nice clean white. Looks really pretty. Pure white, this is a soft white. It's still warm, it's just not as stark. I like that. I like that softness. Alabaster. So alabaster is really popular, but it has more yellow in it. The yellow and the pink aren't super happy together. So if you currently have warm trim with yellow in it, modern gray might not be so hot. And I would definitely lean towards high reflective white or pure white. It's a really nice combo with modern gray. So there you go. That's modern gray. I hope you enjoyed. I do have many hundreds of blog posts and color reviews and an awesome Instagram feed, and I hope you'll visit. Thank you very much.